नमस्कार, मी रवींद्र बोंद्रे, आदर्श विद्यालय चिखली, इथे विज्ञान दोन हा विषय शिकवतो. आदर्श विद्यालय चिखली आणि इजी टेस्ट ॲप यांच्या माध्यमातून मी आपल्यासमोर आजचा पाठ घेत आहे. तर पाठाचं नाव लाईफ प्रोसेसेस इन लिव्हिंग ऑर्गॅनिझम्स पार्ट टू, युनिट आहे सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन ह्युमन बीइंग्स. आणि यामध्ये आपल्याला घ्यायचं आहे मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव्ह सिस्टीम ऑफ ह्युमन. आपल्याला आज टॉपिक बघायचा आहे. वी हॅव सीन यस्टरडे अबाउट सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन प्लांट्स. नाउ टुडे वी आर स्टडिंग द सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन ह्युमन बीइंग्स अँड इन दॅट मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव्ह सिस्टीम ऑफ ह्युमन. सो दिस इज द डायग्राम ऑफ कम्प्लीट मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव्ह सिस्टीम इन ह्युमन बीइंग्स. Now it contains different parts. The main parts are a pair of testes. These two yellow colored. This is pair of testes. Then urinary bladder. Then penis. These are some of the main parts of the and different glands and vesicles. Seminal vesicles, then prostate glands, then corpus glands. These are some of glands and vesicles. These are all the parts of the male reproductive system of humans. We shall study one by one. So there is a pair of testes present in human beings, male reproductive system, and this testes is in pairs and it secrete a hormone called testosterone. The name of hormone secreted by testes is testosterone during puberty, and this testosterone brings the changes in the males during puberty. All the changes that occurs during puberty are due to this testosterone hormone. So these testes are located in a bag like structure on both the sides. It is called scrotum and it is present outside the abdominal cavity. Only this scrotum and testes, they are present outside the body in abdominal cavity. Other parts are present inside the body. Because the reason of this is the function of testes is to produce sperms. And for production of sperms, the temperature required is near about 35 degrees Celsius. And our body temperature is 37 degrees Celsius, as we know. So, it is less than body temperature, the temperature required for formation of sperm. And hence, testes are located in the scrotum outside the body in the abdominal cavity. Then, inside the testes, they contains seminiferous vesicle. Seminiferous tubules. The testes contains seminiferous tubules. Inside the seminiferous tubules are present the germinal epithelium. There is a germinal epithelium. Germinal epithelium, and in this germinal epithelium of seminiferous tubules, meiosis takes place and the sperms are formed. These sperms are formed, they have to travel in various stages. The different stages or roots are: the first root is rete testis, then vas efferens, then epididymis, then vas deferens, then ejaculatory duct, and the last is this one, urogenital gland or urogenital duct, not gland, duct. So this is the route by which the sperm had to travel, and by this route the sperm travels, and during this traveling it becomes mature. So again listen, the inside the testis there is seminiferous tubule. In this seminiferous tubules, inside this germinal epithelium is present, which divides by meiosis to form large number of sperms, and these sperms, for their, they are immature, they are not mature, for their maturity they have to travel through retained testis, vas efferens, then epididymis, vas deferens, ejaculatory duct, and the urogenital duct. So these are different route, and by this route the sperm become mature, and then they are able to fertilize the ovum or female gamete. So this is all about testis. Then here this long tube, it's called vas deferens, as we have seen vas deferens, and this epididymis is near about 6 meter in length. So it is in the form of tube which are coiled, and the length is 6 meter, and hence the sperm have to travel the distance of 6 meter. Then here at the top there is a urinary bladder, this one urinary bladder. Where urine is stored, and this urine is coming from these two glands, these two glands, or these are two pipe-like structures which are coming from kidney. So in kidney, purification of blood takes place, and urine is formed, and this urine is carried from left kidney and right kidney, it is stored in what is called the urinary bladder, and it is thrown outside the body when we have urge. At that time it is thrown outside the body through the penis. This is the penis, it is thrown outside the body, the penis. Then there are two glands, one gland is called prostate gland. Now this gland, listen, this is called a prostate gland, and other gland is Cowper's glands. This is called copper gland in pair. So the sperm, when they travel, we have seen the route. So this travel through this testis, then last one is vas deferens, and then they come here in this what is called urogenital duct, in which the secretion from seminal vesicle, secretion from Cowper's gland, secretion from prostate gland, all they mix, and this combination of sperm, the secretion from seminal vesicle, secretion from prostate gland, secretion from Cowper's gland, all the secretion along with sperm, this combined is called semen. And then this semen is ejaculated out through the penis, and it enters in the vagina during sexual contact. So each sperm have to travel a distance of near about 6.5 meter every time to reach the vagina in the female. So for that the sperm requires energy. So we have seen this is the complete structure of male reproductive system. Now what is sperm? We have seen sperm is a male gamete. They are millions in numbers. They are formed during puberty by after secretion of testosterone. So each sperm, now we shall see structure of sperm. Each sperm is like this. The length of sperm is 60 micrometer, and this sperm has to travel from this epididymis to penis, this route. Inside it there are large number of coil vesicles. This travels in this manner from both sides, and during this there in this semen or in this sperm there is mixing of the secretion of seminal vesicle, secretion of prostate gland, secretion of copular gland, and all they combinedly called as we have seen semen. And this semen contains fructose which supply energy to travel the sperm right from this testis to the penis, and this distance, and from this penis the sperm or semen ejaculated fastly, it enter in the vagina of the female, and this distance is near about 6.5 meter, and hence each sperm require energy. This energy is supplied by the fructose which is present in the semen. And here each sperm has two parts, head and tail. A head and tail. So there are millions of sperms present or formed in the testis. So that is all about the structure of male reproductive system of human. So there are some points related to this system. We shall see them one by one. It is said that the age of marriage in India of a girl and a boy is decided 18 in girl and 21 in boys. It is decided by court, government of India, because at this age all the reproductive organs in girls and boys are mature, and hence they are ready for reproduction, and hence this age is decided. Now how sex is determined in human being? Now in human being the chromosome number is 46, as we know this chromosome number is always in even number. 46, 44 plus XX, 44 plus XY. In female, 44 autosomes. Autosomes means the chromosomes which do not take part in the sex. And these are sex chromosomes, XX. 44 plus 2, 46. In males, 44 autosomes and 2 sex chromosomes, X and Y. This sex chromosome, due to this sex chromosomes, there are some changes in the males and females. Structural changes, we can, body changes. This is due to this sex chromosomes. Now, when meiosis takes place, at that time, meiosis means, we have seen yesterday, the reduction division, where chromosome number is reduced to half. So, 22 and plus X. In male or 22 plus 1, because in female 22 plus X, because both the chromosomes are X chromosomes, so only 22 plus X. However, in female they are 22 plus X, 22 plus 1. So these are the chromosomes after meiosis. Now, when, how the gender decided? Gender means link. The gender decided in this way. Suppose male 22 plus X or 22 plus Y. Then female 22 plus X, because both the chromosomes are X chromosomes. Now when the union of 22 plus X and 22 plus X chromosome takes place, means male gamete is 22 plus X, female gamete is same, only one. Then the gender which is formed is, it is a girl. When the union of 22 plus Y and 22 plus X, this, then 44 plus XY, and gender is what is called male. And hence, the chances of formation of males and females means the girl or boy, they are 50%. In every living organisms, the chances of formation of the males and females, or boys and girls in human beings, they are 50%. Or then the question is there, who decides the gender? So naturally, the male decides the gender, because male contains Y chromosome. In female only X chromosome is there. So due to this Y chromosome, then what happens? It decides whether the gender is boy or gender is girl. If 22 plus X of male and 22 plus X of female combines, 44 plus XX, girl is born. So it is said that male. Then if 22 plus Y chromosome combines with 22 plus X of female, then a boy is formed having 44 plus XY. And hence, no doubt, it is the male who decide the gender of a child and not the female. But in India, due to lack of knowledge or ignorance or some beliefs, it is decided that the girls or females are responsible for formation of girls. So actually, they are male, man, human being, male is responsible for the deciding of what is called gender. So, this is all about the human male reproductive system. So, some questions for you. The first questions for homework: which hormones are responsible for changes in human body occurring during onset of sexual maturity? Is the first question. Second one: why has Government of India enacted the law to fix the minimum age of marriage as 18 in girls and 21 in boys? The answer we have seen. Then, who determines the sex in human beings and how? We have seen just. And name the hormones related with male reproductive system. So these are the questions for homework for today. So that is all about human male reproductive system. Thanks.